Hi, and welcome to Cut the Crap, the podcast. My name is Laman, and I'm going to be hosting real people having real conversations. I find that health stems well beyond your food and weight, and that with the right conversation, not only can you gain perspective, but spark positive, lasting change. Now, without further ado, let's get into today's conversation. Welcome, Lara.
Thank you.
How are you?
Good. And to Amnini.
Shireen has a lot of very important questions to ask you to start. But I'm so excited you're here. Honestly, I know you and Shireen have a history and you know each other.
We have a history.
You have a history.
There's also a connection. I know your sister very well.
Exactly.
That's awal mara that you and I meet.
Yes.
So that's,
But I've always watched you from just what I've seen, and I know your sister very
well.
Yes,
that's true. Yeah.
And I have such a respect for you in the sense that I see someone going into an industry, whatever industry that is, especially a tough industry, because I face the same thing with the podcast. And no one really does a podcast and they're speaking English and Arabic. But I have a lot of respect about that.
Thank you.
And then now she's going to ask you a very important question.
No, على طول. لا بس بجد والله يعني لارا من الناس اللي بجد different. يعني عملوا حاجة بتاعتهم لوحدهم تماما. محدش شبهها من أول ما ابتدت لغاية دلوقتي. It's very interesting.
Oh, thank you.
As you can manage
it. It is because you started off so young. Okay, how old were you when you first started for Star Academy?
Well, دخلت Star Academy, I had just turned 18.
Okay.
So my career started at 18 technically.
Yeah.
Well, I'm currently 29, so it's been 11 years. كتير قوي صراحة. I've been in this industry for quite a long time for someone of my age.
Yeah.
I don't know.
But it's such a good amount of time to go through that evolution.
Definitely. Mm. I mean, the person that I was at 18, I wasn't her at 20, and I wasn't her at 23, and I wasn't her at 25, and so on.
Yeah.
Well, I think that the blessing that I had was that because I started at such a young age, it was a blessing and a curse, to be very honest. I discovered myself, يمكن أبدر شوية than most of my friends. عشان أنا لما كنت دخلت a reality show and I became well known, my friends were just starting university and just starting a new chapter of their lives. When I came in, كنت ببتدي another chapter of my life. It's just completely different paths. The curse was in no, I didn't see eye to eye with people my age anymore. عشان I grew up way too fast.
Yeah.
But the blessing can in no, I saw so much at such a young age, or I experienced so much, and no khalas, I came to a certain age, like I was 26, 27, and I really, khalas, I knew, or even before that, I knew what was important in life, and it was kind of, I had this struggle. I mean, I remember the first 3 years after I came out of Star Academy, and I was doing this for a living, I had a lot of issues. And Shireen Arfa, my friends that have been my friends since I was two are the same friends I have now. I'm not the kind of person who changes friends. And a sahabi that I grew up with, sahabi l'ghay dilwati. But we did have this struggle where we didn't go through the same things in life anymore. My priorities were different, their priorities were different. So it was a bit tough. But at the end of the day, I was doing what I loved. And I had amazing support from the people who were backing me, including them. So I was very, very lucky for that.
I want to tap into this.
And I started with Star Academy.
You went into Star Academy 11 years ago. But the idea of constantly being recorded is not a common, it wasn't a common thing. That's everyone takes videos of themselves.
Yeah.
Everyone's publicizing themselves anyway. It was new.
Yeah.
I heard you say in one of the interviews that we were binge watching yesterday.
And
you said, Loma, they right off the bat, they put you in a storyline.
Yeah.
اللي هو الفيديو اللي هو مش عارفة لو ناس شافته ولا لا بس ممكن نشرحه انه ازاي هما قدموا لارا في ستار اكاديمي وروا هي عايشة فين هي عايشة في بيت عامل ازاي حياتها ازاي حملوها كأنها برنسس لارا وكان انت قلتي انه ده كان بالنسبة لك مش حب ما كنتيش حابة قوي
لا خالص
انه حطوكي في حتة معينة
من غير ما ياخدوا اذني كمان
بالزبط.
من غير ما يسألوني او من غير ما يقولولي طب بصي احنا هنعمل كده او whatever انا كنت على stage star academy او البرايم وورايا قبل ما ابتدي اغني الاغنية ورايا كان الفيديو بيشتغل وانا زي الناس اللي on TV او watching live انا بسمع الانترودكشن زي زيهم وانا سمع وانا سمع حاجات وشوتس actually that my parents had asked them not to take that they took يعني certain shots certain angles of certain people of a certain places no 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 plus narration انا ممكن مثلا اصور حد في اوضه واقول ان اوضه دي از اوضه في مانشن هتصدقوني عشان انا who was in there shooting I'm saying that فالحته دي I didn't like بس كمان keep in mind I was 18 years old I knew right from wrong but at the end of the day I wanted to play the game as much as I could so I could move forward so I could be there I could be present I could go as far as I wanted to go
بس حاسه ان ده حطك في
ايه يعني انا حاسه انه ده للاسف احنا عايشين في عالم that for a lot of people they see it black and white مع انه العالم مش black and white there's so many colors in between
true
ولما الناس يعني لما you're introduced in a certain category people don't take the time to judge you and judge you of their own judgment they take you at face value from what people introduced you as they're like oh yeah but or this is it oh خلاص they said that she's like this so she must be like this well but I didn't just one thing out of full respect to everyone so what
yeah
really so what I've learned my entire life that what you have is not who you are and who you are is not what you have you can have everything in the world materialistically but be a crappy person and you can have nothing in the world be an amazing person and vice versa فانا بالنسبه لي طبعا كان burden عشان people decided that just because I was like this meant that I didn't deserve what I got or I didn't work hard for what I got or whatever yeah. يعني the typical stereotypes اللي بتيجي with this kind of image طبعا
we were just saying this yesterday على حته work hard like we talked about it after as I can think about it people will see this and think it over oh she has it so easy I don't think anyone has it easy
no
I
mean, no one
I
has
really
it
don't
easy.
Think anyone has it easy everyone has to figure something out for 100%. Themselves but to me I'm like what I respect out of you is the fact that you come from a background where you weren't born into the need to hustle right and or the background of this industry but maybe you don't have all the insights
خالص.
And you threw yourself into it and you're like you said everyone expected a week or two I'll be homesick and I proved them wrong and I was like baguette bravo good job like you're so young at the time to say I'm gonna go asan yani to be in a place you're constantly bisawaruki hatta when you're sleeping
yeah
that's
creepy as
so
hell
much, that's so much pressure but even if any whatever way you get to what you're doing you have to show up for it yani you
100%.
Have to plan it and you have to attend and then you have to follow up and you have to be cordial and nice that takes a lot of hard work for Anna Benizbeli we were saying yesterday usually you'll see people that come from a fortunate background don't make it because they're not used to the يعني مش متربيين عندهم حتة اللي هو hard work والناس عادة اللي بتتربى with less بيبقى عندهم الhunger ده فبيتعودوا أكتر for this is like I respect that for the reason we bring it up is the idea at the social media or TV at the
keep
time.
In mind what see Anna McKenzie social,
social
media
la
Doragodi we had Facebook with YouTube with Twitter can list satala you didn't have that insta famous kind of mentality and of blacks and at my time عشان McKenzie social media it was reality shows
the reason I think this is an important point لانه Anna I want to know from you internally between you and yourself this put a lot of speed bumps for you as a 100%. Human ليه كل حاج thinks I don't deserve this or why do people think it's so easy I'm working so hard this
see,
is interesting
for me for a long time in my life I felt like I had to feel guilty for having what I had and this is مش بقول كده to victimize myself I really come to a point right now where I really don't give a damn anymore
you shouldn't
I don't really and with all due respect بس From 18 to 29, 11 years along the way, I had to feel guilty for what I had. فابتديت أقعد مع نفسي وأفكر, okay, are they right? Is it true that I don't deserve this? طب, should I not do this anymore? طب, should I stop? طب, whatever. And I started internally apologizing for who I was. Never outside, because I had too much pride for that. And because I know that if I did, my family and my friends would kill me, because they always made me feel like, لا بالعكس, I shouldn't be apologetic. I deserve it. But deep down inside, كنت حاسة بذنب, the sort of guilt in, why am I here? Maybe they're right and whatever. By then, bit by bit, I just started realizing, you know what? First of all, if you look at my career, the last 11 years, it wasn't consistent. But it wasn't consistent because I chose for it not to be consistent. عشان أنا تربيت في بيت where when there were more important things going on, you stop what you're doing and you care for your family and your friends. And I had situations in my life where I had to take care of certain things. And that was more important to me than being famous or having thousands of followers or having 500,000 hits, whatever. فأنا بالنسبة لي, it was around that time that I started to feel that I shouldn't be apologetic because I'm someone, أنا عارفة priorities في حياتي. I know when I need to be present for my fans and I know when I need to be present for the people that I love. And it was that moment in my life when I started to feel like, you know what? If I want to be who I am and if I think I deserve it, then I do. And no one knows how hard I work as much as I do and the people around me. خلاص, you come to a point where if everyone makes you feel like you're a certain something, حتى if you don't believe it, you end up believing it. Until بتصحي يوم وبتقولي لنفسك, you know what, who are you to dictate who I am and what I deserve and how I really am, and just because you think I have or I don't have something doesn't mean that you know what I deserve and what I don't deserve.
أيوة, بس انت بتقولي على حاجة ان انت كنت حاسة ان انت you don't deserve it.
You know, she's fortunate or she's whatever, she's buying her way through, or she's fortunate or whatever, she doesn't deserve it. What about people who are struggling? Who are you to define what a struggle is? Inti mean or inta mean? عشان to sit down and tell me my struggle is less than someone else's. There's no such thing. أنا حاجة في الحياة أساساً that I really believe in, إنه life is based on relativity. Relativity دي مش عارف أترجمها.
لا, دي شغلانة
شديدة. عشان نبواتين بس. But everything in life is relative. You have problems, I have problems. They might not be the same. But my problems for my life are bad and deep and important to me. And your problems concerning your life are bad enough for you. I felt like I didn't deserve it عشان كنت حاسة إنه okay, what if someone who really مثلا can't get it and wants it more than me, whatever. But I didn't take the easy way out. ما رحتش لحد وقلت لهم here, spend money on me, create an album for me, make me a music video. I did everything correctly, ethically. I went on a reality show زي كل حد تاني. I exposed my life at the expense of other people's lives. عشان أوصل لهدف معين وعشان أعمل what everyone else that was with me did.
بس أنت مش فاكرة مواقف معينة حصلت لك كانت بالنسبة لك اللي هو زي كده اللي هو أو نزلتك لتحت أو فيها مثلا أكيد في الـ 11 سنة
بصي itself كان في comments كده اللي هو
yeah, بصي هو كان صراحة شيرين to be very honest ما فيش حاجة معينة ليه عشان first of all, over the span of 11 years, أكيد في حاجات كتير أوي حصلت, but I can't think of one specific thing. But عشان it's always the same kind of thing. And like Laman is saying, and مثلا في الأكاديمي, كان okay, and why is she here? Look at, أساسا كان في, أنا عمري ما هنسى الموضوع ده. في فيديو, تعرف لما بتطلعي, بتتفرجي على الحاجات بقى بعدين where you weren't around. في كمية videos actually مش واحدة أو اتنين واحدة تلاتة منهم بيكلموا على أهلي really weird information that I've never heard of in my life أساساً فيديو تاني واحد بيسأل حد تاني أنت عايشة فين في مصر وهي عايشة فين في مصر إيه الفرق ما بين الاتنين وطبعاً like this you know, this idea of like, oh, she lives somewhere where like they don't care about each other, the neighbors don't care about each other.
When I شاف حتة
فبتتفرجي على حاجات معينة بعدين بتقولي لنفسك طب يعني أنت في الفيديو ده وأنتي في الفيديو دي ما تيجوا تسألوني أنا بدل ما تسألوا بعض وتكلموا عليا من ورا ظهري. وبالوي أنا مش الوحيدة, أنا في الشوز كده كل حد بيتكلم على التاني من ورا ظهره, فأنا مش بقول إن أنا الوحيدة اللي قعدت وكل حد بيتكلم عني, not at all. But now we're talking about my situation. وبعدين بعد كده لما طلعت من الرياليتي شو وكملت, it was kind of نفس النراتيف.
يعني كان عندك مشكلة انت ما بتكلمنيش عربي,
وبعدين كان كمان ان انا مش بغني عربي, فانا بالنسبة لهم خوياية, فانا مش I'm not Egyptian enough, بس I'm not foreign enough to be accepted internationally, بس انا لسه I'm not Egyptian enough for Egypt. طب again, then who am I? What do I deserve?
So that is a good question. Did you ever think to yourself, طب أنا أخش Star Academy وأنا بحب أغني in all these other languages, العربي بتاعي is not amazing, I'm gonna figure it out?
Definitely. بصي أنا لما دخلت Star Academy دخلت for one reason, عشان اللي كان كسب the year before me ما كانش بيغني بالعربي. So that was my way in. That was actually السنة بتاعتي كانت أول سنة that they announced that you don't have to sing Arabic to be able to get in.
Oh, no way.
Yeah. But to be fair, that's why دخلت.
Okay.
بس it's after, when you want to start a career, وابتديت أغني بالإنجليش, I was known to sing in languages other than Arabic. وحتى when I tried to sing Arabic, كان style بتاعي والvocal abilities بتاعي محدودة لتكنيك معين in terms of Arabic music. That كمان can feel criticism إنه why is she doing this, like why is she singing.
انتي مش هتتشاري, انتي بتغني انجليزي في بلد عربية, انتي عمرك ما هتنجحي في مصر.
اوكي بس عايزة اعمل كومنت على الحتة دي,
which is not wrong على فكرة.
لا بس انتي كان اكيد الموضوع ده برضو يضايق, ان انتي في الاخر انتي عايزة تنجحي في الميدل ايست, فلو عندك ناس كتيرة بتمسكك وتتريق عليكي في الحتة دي وشايفين انه لارا ما انتش بتغني عربي هتنجحي ازاي.
بس عشان كده بقول لك هما مش غلطانين, يعني في حاجات اقدر اقول لك اتس انفير, وفي حاجات اقدر اقول لك نو اتس فير. ات واز فير ان الناس تقول كده, دي مش معناها ان انا ما كملتش اعمل اللي انا عايز اعمله فور شور, بس اتس فير. عشان بصي اللي حصل لما غيرت شويه ابتديت اغني بالعربي اكتر, ات تشينجد ماي دايركشن, ات تشينجد هاو بيبل ستارتد تو فيو مي از ان ارتست از ا سينجر, which is not wrong. بس أنا كنت طول الوقت بقول حتى في الانترفيوز أنا هبتدي أغني عربي under two conditions. لما أنا أقرر إنه it's my time, ولما ألاقي my own sound. عشان I'm not like anyone else in the sense of مش هقدر أعمل اللي هما بيعملوه. I wish I could, but I don't have it. I don't have the capabilities. Just like they don't know how to do what other artists know how to do. ما كل حد عنده
style بتاعه.
فلما أنا ألاقي اللون بتاعي أو style بتاعي, يبقى I'll go into it.
But do you not know how like how bold that is? إنك أنت داخل حاجة بقالها decades and centuries بطريقة معينة, and you're like أنا I'm gonna pave my way through it.
Definitely.
And they're not the easiest of crowds. يعني I don't see an issue with
they ain't easy at all.
Not easy خالص. But the thing is, يعني أنا كنت لسه بقول شيء. بقولها يعني I have won Grammys and Oscars in the shower. فاهمة? I don't know what the Arabic version of these awards are. I've envisioned that I'm Christina Aguilera. I can't sing for my life, by the way. يعني I can barely speak properly. بس إنه في ليه يعني why are we limiting the Arab world إن هما بس هيسمعوا عربي
100%. And this is why for so long كنت بغني in the style and in the language that I wanted.
Yeah.
عشان حسيت إنه طب okay, if no one's opened your eyes to something before, why not allow someone else to do it? يعني just because something isn't there doesn't mean it's wrong.
Right.
You know what I mean? Just because something عشان you don't know something,
it hasn't been done before.
It hasn't been done or you don't know it. مشكلة ان احنا في العالم كله and especially here في الوطن العربي احنا خايفين من what we don't know. احنا
worse. Change.
Yes, from change. There's nothing wrong with change. وبعدين احلى حاجة about change ان انت ممكن تقرري if you like it or you don't.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, see it and you have every right ان انت تقولي لا, I don't like it. بس give it a try. Just أنا, it's the stupidest example, بس أنا وأنا صغيرة كان ممنوع أقول إن أنا ما أحبش أكل حاجة.
الأمهات ولا
you know? ممنوع. يعني أنا وأختي كنا بنحب ناكل كل حاجة. ومامتي كانت تقعد تقول لي, you don't know until you try. You try it and then you say you like it or you don't like it. And this is how I view art.
Look at how this trickled into more important things in life.
Thank you, mommy. No, but really, هو ما ينفعش ان انت تقولي ان انت ما تعرفيش حاجة او خايفة أو مش خايفة بس ما تعرفيش حاجة عمرك ما سمعتيها فلا لا لا I don't like it, I don't like it.
Well, I feel like if there's لو في حد one person who does it or wants to do it one way على الأقل في عشرة تانيين
that want the same thing. أكيد 100% زي ما بقولك مثلا أنا ليه دخلت Star Academy عشان كان في حد قبليا that paved the way to do this whether they liked him whether they liked me and so many people came after that يعني أنا كنت that happened season 5 أنا دخلت في season 6 لغاية season 11 كان خلاص في ناس that only sing in foreign languages he paved the way for myself and then I did for someone else and on and on and on forget Star Academy خلينا نتكلم على the industry right now as it is دلوقتي بتسمعوا كمان with the age of social media وكل حاجة في مجال انه كل حد يتسمع there is something for everyone but when I was starting off it was more limited كان في تلفزيون ويوتيوب بس فهو حسب what they want to watch on TV وحسب what they want to click and watch on YouTube ما كانش في this wide range but then again I will say I did what I wanted to do and I'm proud of it I now in this stage of my life I don't apologize for it I found people who liked it and I found people who don't like it and أنا طول الوقت بقول in terms of music if we're talking musically I experiment يعني if you listen to my first single it's nothing like a taboor أول single بتاعي كان it was an English song it was super pop like super hardcore like the typical formula of a pop song وطابور مش كده والأغاني اللي في النص مش كده there's no right or wrong and you can't ما ينفعش إنه حد يقعد يقول أصلا أنا بعمل كده وأنا بغني كده وأنا مش عارف إيه لا أنت ممكن تصحي one day and you just want to experiment you want to discover yourself
this is art
this is it is and it's And it's over time, يعني my first single I was 19, my last single I was 28. Obviously مش هغني نفس الحاجة ولا نفس اللون ولا نفس الستايل ولا نفس التكنيك ولا نفس اللغة. It's sort of the situation where you just need to evolve.
واللي انت السنين دي كلها هي اللي وصلتك دلوقتي لأغنية الطابور. لقيتي تقريبا اللي انت عايزه شويه انه ده اللي انا حباه او ده لو بالعربي بس في نفس الوقت لسه فيها انتي فاهمة قصدي مش اللي هو انتي سمعتي كلام الناس لا لا انا هحاول اغني زي شيرين مثلا
ايوه
وانتي لو كنت غنيتي حتى زي شيرين كنتش تنجحي
طبعا لا
انتي نجحتي عشان انتي you're different انتي عملتي قدمتي حاجة جديدة
of course بس انا كمان لو حاولت اغني مثلا زي شيرين او زي اي من اي حد من these amazing artists انا ما كنتش هبقى مبسوطة دي بالنسبة لي this is like the conclusion of everything It's not about مثلا ما كنتش انجح ده اكيد ما كنتش انجح يعني كنت تداري على نفسي
حتى لو كنت
بس I would have been miserable ليه اعمل يعني ليه انت تصحي كل يوم الصبح وتعملي حاجه that you're not happy about well this is why كمان so many people ask me you've been in the industry for so long but your career has been like so like up and down up and down you know why because I woke up one day and realized that I wanted to take a break and I did I took a break I woke up a year later and realized that I wanted to work again so I worked again why did I take a break because I realized إنه أنا كان في فترة في حياتي where I was working so hard I wasn't around I missed out on friendships I missed out on relationships I wasn't there for people around me when they needed me and I realized there were more important things than that
there's so many life lessons that are like coming up if I'm not sure if I'm sick for any one of you but يعني here's the one thing I can relate to on a not so relevant scale لما أنا وشيرين قعدنا في الأول and we came up with the idea that we want to record the conversations we were having in general and share some information from the both of us قعدنا نكتب ها بالعربي ولا بالإنجليش لا لازم عربي عشان we're doing it في العالم العربي بس أنا مش هقدر أوصل اللي أنا بحاول أوصله بالعربي طب هنعمل إيه and I was like the fact is The point, the objective, is what we're trying to communicate.
It's not the language.
It's not the language. So it's, أنا بحاول أوصل a conversation. So I'm gonna have to figure it out as I go. And we have been figuring it out again on a daily basis from like how many cameras there are, how many mics, what's the background. And we're doing it in a way where we're not stressing ourselves over it because to me, I have one priority. I wanna have a good conversation. Mm-hmm. I want you to leave feeling like, This was a really good conversation. Yeah. I want anyone watching to be like, oh my God, I'm so glad they talked about this. Like, yeah. I wanted to hear Lara say this. I wanted to know this from her. You know, like, to have actual conversations. Like, no one sent you a script before we sat down.
I had no clue.
We didn't even know how to introduce the episode. Aslan. But you know what I mean?
That lawyer.
I approved. بس ف يعني ف I get that, and to me it's like okay ما فيش قوي الموضوع ده انت you're just talking and you're going back and forth بس too bad like حامل ايه طيب ما هي كده you know
بس اللي انا فكرت فيه دلوقتي وانتوا بتتكلموا انه ناس كتير قوي برضه هتتفرج لارا she's 29 لسه صغيره اوكي وانت تقريبا لسه في ال 20s احنا عندنا لاتي جي لو شاكيرا مدينا
خلاص صراحه
يعني انا I'm actually excited انا
تمام now I'm looking forward to 43 and 50
ان انت مثلا اي حد هيتفرج دلوقتي هيقول يعني you're lucky ان انت او عملتي كده ازاي توصلي ان انت تبقي عارفه انت مين مش فري لكلام الناس انه ايا كان مين في الاندستري هيشتغل ايه في حياته وكده صعب قوي كل حد بيقعد يقول انا مين انا عايز اعمل ايه ازاي ما يهمنيش كلام الناس انه معظم الناس اللي عايزه تعمل حاجه في حياتها يا بيفكر يا مش عارفين هم عايزين يعملوا ايه بيبقوا عارفين هم عايزين يعملوا ايه بس خايفين مش عارفين هم كويسين كفايه ان هم يعملوا كده وخايفين الناس هتقول ايه لما انا اعمل ايا كان هعمل ايه فاهمه
انا فاهمه بصي انا بالنسبه لي I always say this I يعني لو اقول لك one thing I'm blessed or I'm lucky for without being like emo يعني about all of this is not
emo
يعني emotional
بس بعدين
انا بس بفهم بس بتعلم emo كلمه دي ممكن استخدمها
صراحه اهلي number one والناس that I've been surrounded by my whole life يعني انت بتقولي ازاي عرفتي انت مين where this I did because انا from اساسا قبل ما دخلت مجال الفن My parents were always very, أول حاجة, they were very loving. يعني, يعني the most thing كانوا عايزين to show us our whole lives that we were loved. ومش بدلعة, مش بأي حاجة, لا. Our parents يعني, always showed us that we were loved. When you, لما بتتربي في بيت where you always feel like someone loves you and cares about you, you're much more fulfilled إن أنت تقعدي تفكري في حاجات تانية.
You're not seeking it from outside.
Exactly. بس ده مش بينكر انه لسه يعني كلام الناس بيزعلك and it makes you feel bad and it blah 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 بس there's that base تاني حاجة لما دخلت مجال الفن my parents were very involved بمعنى ايه ان انا مامتي مثلا قعدت سنين بتيجي معايا كل انترفيو بتسافر معايا لما لازم اسافر she's with me in every shoot there was always this authoritarian figure إنه لا أنا بنتي صغيرة بس she has a parent there ف you're never gonna be able to take advantage تضحكوا عليها there's always someone there at the same time الموضوع ده خلاني always to be very grounded عشان عمري ما for a second I could like put my head in the air and be like oh look what I'm doing my parents were always there my sister she was always there صحابي like I said اللي كانوا يعني دلوقتي بقالنا 29 سنة صحاب literally Shiri knows them all, Yani. They're the same guys and girls that I
have
grew up with.
Have you not even okay?
It's never changed.
You have your closest friends, but have there been acquaintances along the way that you then realized, you know what, you're not like they're not being supportive or they're jealous or anything. Even if
so
they're
many,
not,
so many. Well, this is why I always realize how lucky I am to have the same friends that I've had along the way.
The
عشان
base.
بالزبط, yeah. عشان But see, your constants are your constants. Any your family, your siblings, your close friends, your cousins, whoever في حياتك is close to you, they're constants. But you have to get to know other people. You have to meet other people. And it's these lessons that teach you, or مش teach you, بس بيفكروكي ليه you have the constants in your life. And the reason why I've been so stable, or I haven't had like, you know, breakdowns and like, thankfully so far like any scandals or anything عشان I've always been so grounded يعني the only time I do what I do as a whatever I am is when I'm outside the house بس once برجع البيت
you're just another member of the family
100% between my friends, I'm probably the most one they make fun of because I think I'm hilarious. They think I'm really lame.
I think I'm hilarious.
my so family funny. And my sister always, you know, I'm always poked fun of. في البيت مع جوزي كمان, he teases me like crazy. يعني I'm not someone who's like a princess when she's back home. You know what I mean? Like I'm this
been
a
red
idiot.
Carpet.
Okay, I feel like when you're raised in a family that's really supportive and you're raised in a certain way where you act with love, you tend to grow up assuming and everyone acts the same way.
100%.
And then you learn sometimes the hard way that it's not. I know you have that support group, these lifelong friends, but I want to know about the toxic people, the acquaintances you've gained and lost along the way, because I feel like that's what a lot of people are going to hesitate when they want to start something new. Loa, الناس هتقول ايه? What about the support? I want to know about that.
Well, see, for me, طبعاً, يعني, I think I'm غلطت في حاجة and I made it sound so perfect and oh my God, I have my family, my friends and they're always there and whatever. Oh, they are. And God bless them 100%. But أكيد along the way, في ناس side كمان, by the way, that are not acquaintances that you meet along the way, ناس that were already there in your life. بس you start to realize certain things about them. أنا في حاجة شيرين عارفاها very well about me, and I don't know how to be fake, really. And people that maybe don't like me very much will be shocked to know that I really don't know how to be fake. But I'm so natural and I don't know how to be fake. بيبان عليا دي مشكلتي. يعني أنا if I don't like you, I won't realize it. بس هعمل like things with my face, you'll just be like Lara, like snap out of it. You know what I mean? But that's my problem. But for me, along the way, عشان طبعاً قابلت ناس في حياتي that were surrounding me, were surrounding my family, were surrounding my friends, that eventually حسيت إن هما they're very toxic. This is very extreme, and it's not something I'm proud of. But أنا, I know how to cut people out of my life.
Mm. But and I do the same. I think no, it,
بس,
you have to.
But أنا مشكلتي إنه I don't know how to be fake with you, right? If I see you, I'll be polite, I'll be respectful, I'll say hi to you. But don't ever expect me to pick up the phone, ask about you, to text you, to say more than hi, how are you to you. And by the way, هو مش معناه أنت you're a bad person. So. It just means that أنا مش قادرة أعمل الإكسترا إفورت to say, oh, how are you, to tell me how you've been. A small talk that أنا بالنسبة لي, it's not something I know how to
you
do.
You always know if someone's asking you because they genuinely care or if they're asking because they just want to know
something about
something.
You. And this is why Anna, out of respect, مش هعمل this thing to someone I don't like. Mm. And if I don't like you, I'm not going to sit here and be like, oh, how are you? Tell me what's new. صراحة, I don't care.
It's true.
I know you don't care about me. I don't care about you. So out of respect for you and respect for the person I want to be in my life, مش هسأل أكتر من كده. How are you? Good. Thank you very much. Okay, nice to see
how
you.
How did you get to that point? Or
I'll tell you how I got to that point. Mainly, يعني. لما, like I said, في الأول, the first few years, كنت حاسة أن my friends and I were not connecting anymore, and I was going through experiences, وهم, they were going through experiences. ابتديت أحس أنه كانوا بيقفلوا على بعض, I was left out. What I started to see حواليهم ناس that were not good for them, and they didn't believe me عشان هما كانوا فاكرين ان انا I felt left out, ف we weren't seeing eye to eye. When in the meantime انا ابتديت اتصاحب على ناس that were filling the void of my friends عشان I needed, انا كنت محتاجه ناس عايشين نفس الحياه, شايفين نفس الاكسبيرينسز. وبعدين ابتديت اشوف انه the people around me, they weren't like, يعني كنت طول الوقت I compare them to my friends, they weren't like my friends. الصحاب that my friends made, I started to see how toxic they were for our friendship.
يعني they were
ازاي كانوا بيشوفوا how close we were and they were trying to break us, and not, I wouldn't say trying to break us apart, بس كانوا يعني كانوا حابين انه they have them under control and I'm not there to influence them, or I'm not there to play a role. وانا في وقتها كنت بسافر كتير قوي, كنت بصور ميوزك فيديوز بتوعي في امريكا, فto go to the states already انت بتبقي مسافره, يعني اسبوعين ثلاثه عقبال ما ترجعي وتعبانه مش قادره تشوفي حد, خلاص ما everything was breaking down. لما my friends and I had a talk years later, we came to a conclusion that okay, you have these toxic people in your life, I have these toxic people, we need each other, we're all we have. This was my aha moment. اللي شفت إنه لأ, يعني this is why you have to pay attention to who's in your life. Because I know I'm an exception.
Yeah.
Fahma, I know that most people have amazing friends that are so good to them, but they haven't been their friends their whole lives. They weren't childhood friends. I feel like everyone is... كل حد عنده situation مختلفة.
Yeah.
You know what
لا,
I mean?
لا, بس لا, في ناس كتيرة عندهم حتة انه الأصحاب, مثلا بيبقى عندهم أصحاب, وكده حتى أقل حاجة, لما حتى بيتجوزوا ويخلفوا.
See how many people you can count on your hands, because these are probably the people that will stay. Oh. But to be fair, بقالي مثلا 6 years أو أكتر, I'm very good friends with people who have been amazing to me through my husband or through, you know what I mean? Like they were his, كانوا هما his constants, so they've become my constants. يعني مثلا شيرين and I are very close كمان عشان our, يعني she's from the extended group that's very good friends with my husband and his best friends, and يعني احنا كلنا بقينا we've been in each other's lives for years. عشان كمان okay, we're not from the same 6 people that grew up together, but we're from the same extended group of people that have been in each other's lives good and bad all the time.
It's an important point ان تبي عارفة انه if you're going through a specific phase or a change وحاسة ان هما the people you were always surrounded with ابتدوا يبقى في اختلاف, there's still, you're gonna evolve and you're gonna meet newer people. Yeah, I'm friends with Shireen's sister and now I'm friends with Shireen. And yeah, you shift and you change depending on انتي فين في حياتك.
Yes,
you know?
Your life experiences.
بس اللي انتو عملتوه والناس كتير ما بتعملوش انه ان انتو قعدتوا وكلمتوا في الموضوع. في ناس قالت لا خلاص ما دام احنا بعدنا we're different.
بس احنا اتكلمنا عشان really انا بالنسبة لي لو انا ما اتكلمتش كنت يعني
تخسرهم.
كنت هخسرهم و really this is very selfish, but أنا, I was in a phase in my life where I had no one but my parents, my sister and these friends.
Yeah.
كنت بشتغل كتير قوي, كنت بسافر كتير قوي, كان كل حد يعني I felt like people were being my friends for the wrong reason. فreally I had no one. Really. يعني I had my parents, I had my sister, I had my grandparents who were everything to me. And I had them, and if I lost them, I wouldn't, خلاص, يعني, what 21-year-old girl doesn't want to have her friends around her? You know what, so. Like, excuse my language, but screw the music, screw the fame, screw this lifestyle. When you come back home, وعندك مثلا شهر مش بتشتغلي فيه, and you have no one to talk to, what is that?
Yeah.
What kind of life is that?
But the exception in the situation, إنه, it's not about that your friends were jealous.
No, it my was, friends were amazing.
You were missing effort from both sides. But I want to know about the people. I'm sure you know all the things people have said or will 100%. Say. Yani, you know, I know.
I might look stupid, but I...
No, by the way, okay, I'm very good at picking up vocabulary from people, even for interviews. And yesterday after we were stalking you.
Yeah, I think, by the way, we yeah, this is really...
We'll show you what we watched. Yeah,
it was interesting. It's a little bit strange, because when we're talking about someone, we're talking about someone, we're talking about someone, we're وبتشوفي بس في interviews مثلا في Star Academy عارفه هو بس انه زيك غريبه.
But I told her, I was like, I know I'm very good at reading people.
Yeah.
And I was analyzing your vocabulary even from when you were at Star Academy when you were 18 years old up until like one of the
recent
interviews. I can tell you have thick skin, and I can tell you're very composed and you're very smart. It's not hard to see that in you, and I respect that because it doesn't take a stupid person or a, you know, a whatever in هي تطلع and to be putting herself out there, and people were very harsh. People were not kind to you in the beginning.
No.
Yeah, you have your fans, but people were harsh, and I'm sure you knew very well what was happening. For I pick up that you're not stupid at all. No, you're not. Didn't I say this?
Yeah, like to think. وهي صغيرة كده من صغيرة أنا بتكلم. انا عايزه الحاجه بتاعتي انا بتكلم حتى
هغنيها بطريقتي هعملها باللي يريحني. You always have these words where you're clarifying كويس قوي ان انا عارفه ان في فرق. I know انا ليا طريقتي. But I really want to know, like, these judgments, right? These things that are being said mm-hmm. about you. How do you cope with that? I know you have the support, but there's
no,
always
but an it's internal. It's internal. It is internal. 100%. Look, and I'm, like I said, I'm someone who... It's really complicated. Like I said, I'm not feeling that the way you deal with something is black or white. I have AM where what people say really matter to you. Mm. You're ready to victimize yourself. And then you have other days when you're reading and you're like, okay. So what?
I'm going to tell you the quote I was going to say. I'm not going to pretend like I know it, but it's such a good one, okay? Okay, it goes, it's not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is mired by dust and sweat and blood, who strives, who errs, who comes short again and again, because there's no effort without error and shortcoming, but who does actually strive to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasm, the great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who neither know victory nor defeat. Meaning, and no, it doesn't matter what you think if you're not in the moment doing what needs to be done, because when you're in the spotlight, you're in putting yourself out there trying, you're going to fail.
Definitely.
It's not a book. Which one? I take her books.
It sounds like a speech.
It's from no, Daring Greatly. No, it's Brené Brown. But I watched it. I didn't read it. But it's true. I have some of her books here too.
Interesting.
This is why we're doing this. But I really liked it. I'm sorry. I read, I was really nervous reading it. خفت أقول حاجة بالغلط ولا حاجة. حسيت نفسي in class reading out loud. But yeah, okay. You know when you read in class and you're like, I don't want to read it wrong?
And your face starts pronunciation to get like hot.
Is it?
No, I'm that telling job. You that's what it feels
like. The pronunciation but ما كانش.
Oh my God, cut bam and out.
الشرين الخبيرة في الحاجات دي طبعا
بس الفكرة بجد الموضوع بس أنا بحس إنه ماشي أنت عندك your family وعندك كل الحاجات دي كلها بس أنا عارفة إن أنت لما بتشعر بس مش عايزة الناس تقول لا خلاص هي أنا عايزة الناس تعرف بس أنت لما بتزعلي عشان بس ما تفتكرش إن أنت لا ما بتزعليش
لا أنا بزعل
لا بتزعلي وبتزعلي جامد أوي يعني أنت ممكن بتقعي ساعات
يعني أنا من النوع إنه مش I don't get angry I don't get frustrated I get hurt يعني I'm a very sensitive person بس من جوايا خالص يعني you usually will never know that you hurt me unless I really care enough about you to tell you listen you hurt me and when I get hurt I do get very upset because I'm a very happy person فلما انت بتزعليني it goes deep and when I get upset I get very upset Well, like I said, if our friendship matters, I will always fight. But if our friendship doesn't matter to me and I feel like it doesn't matter to you, it doesn't matter to me, honestly, there's more important things in life than being in toxic friendships and relationships. Okay. So ممكن نبقى صحاب هاي باي, ممكن نبقى في نفس ال extended group نسلم على بعض ونسأل على بعض كل فين وفين لما حاجة تحصل, you know, good things and bad things نبقى there for each other. بس we don't need to be friends.
بس بياخدك لو انت من الناس اللي موقف واحد ممكن انت بتقفلي ولا لازم يبقى كذا موقف عشان
لا 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 تقفلي. عشان كل حد بيغلط وانا بغلط في الناس زي ما هم بيغلطوا فيا فاكيد مش موقف واحد لو حد بيزعل على موقف واحد يبقى he has to check himself for sure لا انا بالنسبه لي it's time after time after time after not realizing that you're doing something wrong after انا بحاول اوريكي انه there's something going on or whatever لا مش موقف واحد هو ما ينفعش حد يزعل من موقف واحد
يعني I think you can always tell البني ادم ده الانتنشن بتاعه ان هو
بس سايت يو كانت تيل
That's the sometimes problem. You can but sometimes you can
sometimes you can for sure بس بالعكس انا حاسه انه if يعني مثلا you're married and I'm married لو زعلتي مثلا تنطوي by saying something doesn't mean it's over there's more to it friendships and family relationships are like marriages لازم يعني مش كل كلمة هنزعل من بعض, مش كل action هنزعل من بعض. ما لو أنا زعلتك بس أنت عارفة what kind of person I am, مش هتقطعيني من your life, like you'll move on. بس it depends.
Perfect segue to marriage. Because I think you're always asked, does your husband support what you do?
I hate that question. I think it's the most sexist question in the world, because I'm sure people don't go to my husband's shop and ask him if I support what he does.
Exactly.
فأنا بالنسبة لي بقى السؤال ده صراحة, it's all over the world. مش هقول إنه it's only in the Middle East.
Yeah.
It needs to stop.
Oh.
بكره. يعني look at how riled up I got. أو جوزك بيخليكي تغني أو مبسوط باللي أنت بتعمليه أو جوزك he's okay with you traveling. First of all, whether he's okay or not okay, دي حاجة ترجع لي أنا وجوزي.
صح.
You have no right to ask, عشان حتى لو هو he's not okay with it, أكيد
مش هقولك.
يعني أكيد مش هقولك. أه أنت عارفة لا.
He's so upset.
مش فاهمة هو مش مستفزني.
إيه ده؟ First of all, mind your own business. Second of all, we don't sit and ask men if it's okay, يعني what their wives do, if their wives are okay with it. خلاص بقى, get over it. بعدين يعني أنا فاكرة, I remember this so well. I told you this story before. When my husband and I first started dating, وتعرفنا على بعض, we were together for like 4 months or something. أنا ما تسألونيش ليه, بس أنا I always have this intuition. كمان ترجميها عشان ما اعرفش انت
ايش
يعني, احساس كده, يعني احساس انه في حاجه. فانا كنت حاسه انه حد كان قال له حاجه عليا او كان في حاجه. هو ما كانش متغير معايا صراحه, he was amazing. بس بحس انا بعرف so many things happened between us and between other relationships. بحسه ما تسالونيش ليه, I'm right every time. فقلت له هو do people talk to you about me? فقالي what do you mean? قلت له يعني do people بيقولوا لك مثلا انه دي بتغني
هتستحمل ازاي هتستحمل الحياة دي.
قالي honestly قلت له طب what do they say? قالي there's no need يا لارا, وانا يعني I'm not listening to people, what do you care, انه انت مالك الناس بتقول ايه, انا اهو I'm here and I don't know what. I was like no, I want to know, مش عشان حاجة, عشان عايز اعرف what, يعني I want to know what they say, عشان أعرف how it's making you think. نننا قاعد يقول لي كذا حاجة, مثلا يقول لي إنه حد جي قال لي طب يعني أنت مستعد يعني لحياة مع واحدة بتسافر كتير وبتعمل الشغلانة دي وعمرها ما هي هنا في البلد وطول الوقت مسافرة وبتغني ونننا. فقلت أكيد الشخص ده مش شخص متعلم وopen minded, وأكيد الشخص ده حد
نعمل
استني لغاية ما ابتديت يجي لي intuition ان انا حاسة انه عارفة مين الناس اللي بتقوله كده. سألته is it كذا؟ no. كذا into this person. okay. this person. ابتديت احس the kinds of people.
عرفتي من الناس.
الناس دي كانت ناس that are supposed to be very open-minded. سافروا عايشوا برا. ناس انا تربيت معاهم, يعني هم عارفيني, عارفين تربيتي, عارفين اهلي. يعني يمكن عارفني انا شخصيا احسن منه
للاسف.
فانا مش بتكلم انه الناس, بكلم على الناس بيفكروا اي ثوت بيفكروا زيي. فابتديت احس انه اوكي انا عارفه انه in general انا what I do for a living مجال people have in the Middle East عندهم كده stereotype او فكره معينه عنها which is wrong which is right and wrong.
ولو اي حد في الفيلد ده يبقى صايع بس
basically واي حد بيسافر كتير وبيسافر كتير واكيد مثلا they're never او مش mentally here. ف over time ابتديت يعني خلاص جوزي ابتدى يقولي انه الكلام ده قل شوية, مش كل حد بيقوله كده. وبعدين فترة كده كان كل فين وفين مثلا اسافر كتير, طبعا صحابه الولاد حتى صحابي انا بس يتريقوا انه دي مش دي طول الوقت مسافرة, انت طول الوقت جاي مثلا خروجات لوحدك ومش عارفة ايه. طيب انا عارفة ان انتوا بتهرجوا, بس انتوا مش عارفين انه the more you say this the more it's going to be stuck in someone's head.
صح.
يعني انا الحمد لله I'm very lucky ان انا جوزي واحد he has his head on his shoulders. اي حد تاني كان ممكن يبقى paranoid, كان ممكن يجي لي في يوم وليلة يقول لي لا I'm not enjoying this, what are you doing?
He starts repeating all the things.
ثاني حاجة I can guarantee you لو بنت كانت مسافرة بنت كانت قاعدة والراجل مسافر طول الوقت هو بيشتغل
بالضبط.
هو للأسف هو مش هنا بس شغله مضطر يسافر طول الوقت, أصلا he's making money, أصلا he's doing business deals, أصلا he's So am I.
So. أنا بكره رمضان.
وفي ناس كتيرة قوي that are like this and there's a lot of families that, يعني في Arab world and a lot of young couples who have this dynamic ومشين كويس قوي. This is something to be مش كتير.
مش كتير بس ما كمان ما فيش black and white. في ناس وفي ناس.
بس أنا بلوم أفتكر قلتها قبل كده أنا مشكلتي مع الناس اللي في مصر إنه قليلين قوي من البنات اللي هما عندهم عايزين يعملوا حاجة في حياتهم عايزين يشتغلوا عايزين يعملوا حاجة مش بيعملوها عشان الراجل اللي هي عايزة تكون معاه حتى قبل ما يتجوزوا عشان هو مش هيرضى
That's true
فاهمة قصدي
But how could you ever like I think about this all the time I always think okay I know that I could never be with someone who's not gonna be a support system and proud of me and happy for me because I know in Nukhas Gamal like it's 2020 you could be a working wife and a mother you can travel and
no and by the way
you've never gone anywhere but I can't
but not everyone thinks like you
I know and that's the problem and for me like I it took me so much to figure out something to do that I love and that I'm truly passionate about and that I could work all the time
which is
for.
Why the time to lay a head because it took you so long to find something you were passionate about mish had to belly to find someone who'll stop you from all the hard work you've put and all the years you've taken to figure out who you were
I could never not and I've been in situations where I felt like No, I don't sense the support or I don't sense
By
like
the... 100%. So do I. I've been in relationships before. Like, I've fallen in love with people before that... Mashai told me they weren't okay with it because they had no choice. Because keep in mind, I was 18. So anyone I met after that took me as I was. I wasn't, like, I wasn't in a relationship. And then all of a sudden it's like, oh, I'm going to be a singer. No, I'm going to be a superstar. No, Hoa. Until you met me, any person I've met me as I was. But I have been in situations, Taban, where there was this sort of il balance in Nusayat. He's super proud of me and he's bragging about me. And then other times, he's threatened.
Yeah.
Fahma Azdi. And I think, مش هنتاك على بعض. Any person who marries the first person they meet, I say here in the Middle East, like you're not allowed to like be in relationships, like you know what I mean. And it's so it could be completely innocent. You could just be two people in love, which is the way it was with me, Aidi.
Yeah, you're getting to know different people. But
I would have never, loved my husband and fallen for him so hard if I hadn't been broken down on the way by other people.
So.
Yeah.
And you need that. And Timahtega to understand. And why am I in love with this person? عشان I fell for other people who كان فيني الغلط ده في كان فيني الغلط ده في وكان بيعمل كده فيا وانا بشتغل وكان بيعمل كده فيا وانا I was like this and like that and whatever and no one is perfect you don't marry an angel he obviously didn't marry an angel يعني I'm crazy بس you come to a point where when I met him وكان الناس بتقول له حاجات كده عني كان طول الحاجات كل الحاجات دي هو قرر انه you know what and you know Philippe he's like one track minded and he really doesn't care about anything I'll get to know her for who she is لو هي طلعت كده يبقى خلاص هو لحد ما ده عقد ولو ما طلعتش كده يبقى good for both of us it was perfect This is you have to experiment. You have to understand.
I like what you said, and because I've been broken, I was able to fall this much for that kind of person. Because I've been in a situation where, at first, I was like, "Am I doing something wrong?
Mm-hmm.
Is this stupid? Am I delusional?" And then I had to like cut the crap with myself and be like, "No. Listen, look at the results that you're getting. Look at what's happening. The fact that you're up in your." This all escalated really quickly.
Yeah.
Alhamdulillah, very positively. The responses that we get, how many the responses that you get from people, like people have left from this table and written books about their experiences when they never even wanted to be on camera and all these things. For a certain point, I'm like, you know what? This broke me. I'm not gonna lie to you. It broke me.
It needs to break you.
But that's why I can say I can't be in a partnership in a relationship like the next time around it needs to be someone who I could go to and be like what do you think of this and genuinely know that this person is so proud of me as I know all women are of the person they end up with so why are you not expecting the same in return
بس فيليب ودي حاجة أنا صراحة يعني برافو. وبحس انه لو اي يعني هو عشان واثق في نفسه فماضي هو عارف كويس قوي هو مين, هو واثق من نفسه, واثق في لارا اوكي قبل يعني هو واثق في نفسه الاول, فهو يقدر يثق في لارا انه ما عندوش معظم الولاد اللي عندهم مشكله بقى بيغير بزياده مش عايزها ان هي
مشكلة
تكبر وان هي تبقى سكسسفل او هي في اي فيه. حاجه مشكله فيه, هو اللي عنده مشكله جواه مشاكل كتير. هو فيليب مش كده, بالعكس فيليب اصلا في حاجات كتير قوي لارا بتحكي لي بجد ببقى اللي هو الله كويس انه في راجل لسه كده اللي هو بالنسبه لي.
بس كمان شيرين ده عشان زي ما انا I have experienced love and loss هو كمان ما انا ما اخدتش واحد عمره ما حب واحده في حياته all of a sudden he's giving me all his love. لا انا بالنسبه لي يعني بالعكس انا بالنسبه لي I wanted to be with someone who's experienced things who got his heart broken, who broke hearts, who
learned to
felt
do better,
betrayal
be
who's betrayed عشان when we come to a point where we're going to be together, when we come to a point لما هنحب بعض and we go into relationship, our baggage has been there and done that. عملنا اللي كنا لازم نعمله, حبينا and we broke our own hearts, we broke other people's hearts, we had our hearts broken and خلاص we're moving forward now. وبالنسبة لي دي أهم حاجة, وعشان كده I would assume إنه هو he's not that kind of person عشان خلاص he's dealt with what he's dealt with, he's lived his life and I have mine.
Then you build on a clean foundation. Like when I see people like when I hear your story like that in your marriage, mashallah, and other people that I've seen, that makes me so happy and happy for the shifts that are happening and hopeful for myself that I don't have to compromise who I am or what I want to be or
because
do.
Because it's out there.
Because it's out there. And it bothers me so much when I see such smart, young, beautiful girls فجأة are like this and they're just going to get married and I can't wait for the wedding day and the wedding dress. Tab, have you thought about like the day after?
Yeah, about the marriage, not the wedding.
Have you thought about the marriage? Everyone is so obsessed with the wedding day and the henna and the Eid Fatha and the Instagram stories and the hashtag you guys are going to have. Tab, have you thought of the marriage? You're going to have to look at this person المفروض for the rest of your life.
And it's not easy, by the way.
And it's not. But how can you build together if you yourself are not built? يعني انت نفسك ما تكونتيش انك تروحي وتبني حاجة with someone else. I know people who in the last, how many years ago did I cry? 7 years, okay, they got married and divorced. Because it's the years where you're supposed to be figuring out yourself. And you decided, no, I have to get married. It's about this time. Everyone's doing it. All my friends are doing it. I have to do it. Why?
بصي أنا حلومهم لو هما سنهم كبير. بس أنتي من سن صغير. لو عندك أم من وانت صغيرة هي بالنسبة لها
إنه أنا بنتي
ده الألتيميت جول بتاعها. إن أنتي مش عايزة تعملي إيه في حياتك. عايزة تشتري في حياتك. أنتي عايزة تكوني مين. الألتيميت جول بتاعها إنه أنتي هتخشي الجامعة. ماشي خشي الجامعة كويسة. بس أنتي
هتعملي إيه في حياتك. ما بالظبط. بصي إنه basically إنه the people raise their daughter sometime and that goal and then you have to get married and you have to find a nice husband. By the way, all these things are good. أنا مش بلوم أي حد that has this in the back of their minds. بس when لما جوزك يروح الشغل وانت تقعدي في بيتك حتى لو, by the way, my mother was a housewife. You know, my mother was a working woman and then a housewife and then a working woman again and then a housewife. I respect them عشان دي بالنسبة لي it's the hardest job in the world. أساسا. بس when you're sitting and you look around and you don't understand what the purpose of your life is, what are you doing?
Yeah, so that's my issue. Yani, I believe me, one day when I have kids, I think I'll be a stay-at-home mom. I want to deliciously soak up
and
this time.
And I thought for a bit. For a time, I think. I'm not sure what I'm doing in my life. But the day I have my first child, if at that moment in my life, and I want to prioritize everything in my life, I will.
Exactly. That's not my
أهم من الشهرة وأهم من الانستغرام واليوتيوب. أنا مامتي was there my whole life. She was there to raise me. She was there to make every decision in my life with me, and I loved it.
Exactly.
I want to do the same thing.
I think I believe you can have everything, just not all at the same time.
أيوة,
and
exactly.
I think I could work now because me working now means I'm trying to figure out who I am and learn as much about
so
my life.
So when you get to that
exactly.
point.
Exactly. So that because my issue is people getting married and partnering before the, yani getting to know someone when they don't know themselves, because these problems arise later in life.
Definitely.
So to me now, I need to travel and utilize, alhamdulillah, the resources that I have and work and explore who am I, what I like, what I don't, what I'm okay with and what I'm not. So when I partner with someone, then I know what I bring and I can accept what's being brought.
Definitely.
And then I think, yani, whether you stay at home or you work, I think have the choice. The point is, yes, you should have the choice to stay home or not. Yeah. I believe I will be at home with my kids, but then they're going to grow up.
And you realize that you want to do something.
And I'm going to do something. And I'm going to do something. I got May 23 for the honeymoon. حاسه ان انا كنت في وقتها كان مخي ان انا هتجوز واخلف وخلاص that's it
but your life happened after
ايوه بالظبط ان انا حصلي اللي بتقوليه انا حاسه ان طنطو بيروح الشغل حتى قبل ما اخلف طنطو بيروح الشغل انا قاعده في البيت انا بعمل ايه بكلم صيدليه بطبخ لكن طب كل ده بيخلص يعني في ساعه ساعتين طب بقيت اليوم انا بعمل ايه وحتى لما خلفت سليم حسيت انه انا طب سليم مسيره هيكبر ما هيروح النيرسري انا حسيت ان انا extremely depressed حاسه ان انا useless
ايوه
وفي حاجات كتير قوي عايزه اعملها وحاسه انه
بس دي انا شايفه انه النقطه دي is really important عشان انت عارفه كمان you discover parts of yourself after you get married وما فيش حاجه غلط في الموضوع ده يعني like Shireen is saying يعني with me مثلا it happened before I got married with Shireen it happened after بس انت عندك luxury Will you're lucky enough to have someone in your life يخليكي to discover yourself and change your life while you're still in the constant. وده بالنسبة لي it's a luxury that مش كل حد عنده. I think you know, that's very important. إنه أنا مثلا like I said it's the opposite. أنا ابتديت شغلي من 11 سنة. I had time to figure out who I was. I had time أقرر if this is still something I want to do ولا مش عايزة. I met someone who met me at I was who I was. خلاص, there's nothing you can do about it. But I think you know, the more beautiful thing is مثلا what Shireen went through. إنه you got married, you moved on with your life, عشت حياتك مع جوزك, and then you discovered something in your life and you're like, you know what, طنطوي أنا عايز أعمل كده.
I love that you both well done picked partners that allow the space of إحنا we're married but we're still gonna continue to evolve and I know that always evolving too in his work and his lifestyle he's changing also
بس هو بياخد صدمات برضو مش عادية يعني أنا مش مثلا بقوله أنا حامل هفتح restaurant مثلا هو أنا حامل أنا مرة أنا هبقى painting instructor okay من painting instructor هبتدي أعمل فيديوز على يوتيوب
okay
من حامل يوتيوب أنا هبقى مذيعة okay بعد كده أنا همثل بس
عشان أنا كنت عايزة أقول حاجة على فكرة I think إن إحنا بنوري للناس إنه these marriages are so amazing they're super tough وبعدين especially I think مش عايزة أقول what we do عشان in every كل الشغلانة that's demanding بيبقى في struggles in a relationship وحاسة إنه this is something very important to point out يعني أنا my job is weird عشان أنا عندي أوقات مش بشتغل خالص وببقعد في البيت ومش بعمل حاجة وببقى يعني أسعد بنت في العالم عشان أنا بموت أقعد في البيت I love it بس ببقى زهقانة بس ببقى always there when my husband's around but then I have phases in my life مش موجودة وبنبقى مثلا بنخرج وبعدين literally فيليب بيبقى لوحده for like 3 weekends straight you know what I mean and it puts a little strain عشان في الآخر هو بيحس إنه طب okay I support you and you're doing what you want to do but where are you in my life And it's fair.
Of course.
It's very fair.
It's hard work.
It's not easy.
No.
No, it's hard work.
Let's just make that very clear.
No.
I just want to make it a point to anyone listening, thinking, مثلا, if they're in a relationship right now or they're at a crossroads, اللي هو مثلا عايزني أغير حاجة, أصلا عايزني أسافر حتة, or they want, like, you know when you feel obligated to sacrifice pieces of yourself for the well-being of a potential relationship or an existing one because you think that this is the next box to check.
100%.
I think it's really important to know and it's okay to say no. If it's but really
it's okay
eating,
to say yes as well.
And it is okay to say yes, of
your
course.
Situation.
So you need to really just see with yourself, are you going to be able to live with this? And if you can't, you're going to be fine and it's going to be fine and there's going to be someone else.
Of course.
Who's going to, and at the same time, if you want to say yes, your life and your work, there will come a time where the sacrifice is going to be reversed. And it knows, you don't need to figure everything out right now. Because I learned this, like, I love watching Shireen's marriage and their relationship because I see them evolving and I see them, like, testing things out and learning as they go. It's not like, oh, you have to do this at this time and you have to do this, this, you know, by the book.
Definitely.
No, but it's also her
problems. It's
her problems, of course. If he's supporting you, you're supporting him and everything. But when there's برضو كل واحد حياته او بتبعده شويه وكده بيحصل برضو بتطلع بمشاكلها بس انا بحس انه بالعكس ده حاجه حلوه انه
انا كمان انا بحس ان المشاكل دي بت كرييت ا دايالوج والدايالوج ده هيبقى انت بتعملي كذا طب انت بتعمل كذا طب انت ليه مش عارفه وتتكلموا هو you have to speak, you have to discuss these things. عشان تاني مرة لما مثلا let's say I was away for a long time or I was working here shooting a long time whatever تاني مرة أبقى عارفة إنه أوكي مثلاً في الفترة دي أبقى بشتغل كتير قوي فالفترة اللي قبليها وبعديها I have to be present. You know what I mean? I have to go out of my way. عشان at the end of the day هو بيعمل كل حاجة to make me happy and I want to do everything to make him happy. It doesn't always happen.
It's an understanding and a compromise.
It's a compromise. Hi guys, أقولها بقى whoever's watching because I'm dying to say this. أنا مش بكلم على نفسي because الحمد لله everything is fine and
this all is good. Exciting.
Please. When a woman gets married, don't ask her when she's having a child because you don't know what she's going through.
Oh.
Don't ask her if she cooks and cleans because everyone has their own home life. These are sexist questions. الأسئلة دي, they need to stop. Because I don't go to a man and ask him, ha, دلوقتي بتطبخ لمراتك, ناوي مش عارف ايه,
how much are you bringing home? What are you?
Really, these questions are...
بتسألك الأسئلة دي؟
أكيد, عشان كده بقول الموضوع. when you're single or when they think you're single, my relationships are always private. Again, it's in my plan with my husband. It's not in my plan with you and your interview.
It's not part of your identity.
But this is how they think. A woman for them is, okay, she's a superstar, or she's a businesswoman, or she's whatever. But when is she going to be the wife? When is she going to be the mother? When she's the mother of one, when is she going to be the mother of two? When I'm talking about nafsi, why? Because I want to have a family. I want to, and it's in my plans for the future. But... هو ما ينفعش ان انا ابقى قاعده في انترفيو and I'm discussing a project or I'm discussing something مثلا personal and all of a sudden like ها
البيبي سيبك بقى من كل الشغل اللي انت متبهدله عليه
وكل السنين دي
وكل سنين انتي متبهدله فيها وحتى كل الافورت ده هتبقي ام امتى؟
are you a good housewife? Do you cook? Do you clean? What do you cook? طب وانت مش عارفه ايه وانا فاكره حد سالني السؤال ده في الاول when I first got married كنت لسه بتعلم اطبخ وانا by the way أنا
بس فيليب بيعرف
يطبخ
ده حلو قوي هو مش عايز زارة اصلا تطبخ
هو مش محتاجني
في احلى من كده
هو اصلا فيليب بيطبخ حلوه قوي like فيليب's food is amazing and actually فيليب is teaching me how to cook really well so I remember in the very beginning فيليب اساسا بياخد باله قوي من اكله فهو he eats like grilled foods ف اللي انا بعمله في البيت في الاول it was just like grilled food so it wasn't exciting فيقولوا لي ها اتعلمتي ايه او بتطبخي I don't know grilled chicken grilled fish بس مش عارفه تعملي حاجه تانية I was like صراحه جوزي بيحب ياكل كده واساسا he's good like he doesn't need me
لارا بجد بيتعصب لما هي بتبتدي تخش
لازم الكونفرسيشنز تتغير لازم الطريقه والاسئله لازم تتغير ما this is why we're here
بس على فكره ده مش في انترفيوز يا جماعه احنا عايزين ده في الحياه الناس كلها بتقعد تسأل البنات الأسئلة دي امتى هتتجوزي طب بعد ما تخلفي
امتى هتخلفي
بعد ما تخلفي اول واحد مش هتخلفي تاني واحد حرام هتخليه لوحده انا وبابا موجودين افرضوا بصي بتقالي ايه طب لو متوا بس مين معاه
بجد
كلهم انتوا
I can only imagine
بعد ما عيالك خلفتي بيخشوا مدرسة امتى هيخشوا الجامعة امتى فاهمة ما بتخلصش اسكتوا
بالظبط لا وبعدين
I hate getting asked this question.
But it's annoying, but come in. عشان زي ما قلت before that nothing is black and white. And I'm just بقول إنه you're not allowed to ask people this question. But you're allowed if the context allows it. يعني لو you're talking مثلا if you're sitting down for an interview where it's super personal and super one-on-one ومش عارف إيه. بس مش كل interview that a female is being interviewed ها. مش عارف إيه. Baby.
I have a couple friends that have decided that this is the time to get married and have kids, and I love it for them. I really am so happy for them. Yeah. But the only thing they ever ask me when we like connect on the phone
is how.
Hey, bye, Laman. There's no guy. Like, come on. You've been in Egypt for almost a year. You're not gonna get married. Yeah. I'm like, this is all you're gonna ask me about. This is it. And then you start to feel like, am I failing at something? Is this, am I, li- is what's happening?
Like, what's wrong with me? Mm-hmm. Why, you know, why don't I have anyone in my life? Like, it's, I know it's annoying. And it's not everyone. See, this is, again, مش كل حد بيسأل الأسئلة دي, but most people do. We're, يعني, I don't know how to say this, but it's, come on, women in 2020 and 2019 and 2018,
please, it's not
they do
I,
so much it. More than that. يعني, look at, يعني مثلا, this is something actually, and I would love to talk about. My my little cousin, she's an amazing soccer player, and she is on the يعني في منتخب للبنات دلوقتي that they created, and she's on the national team, and حتى before the national team هي بتلعب في وادي دجلة. She's an amazing player. دلوقتي بقى في an opportunity إنه البنات اللي شاطرة في كورة يلعبوا professionally. Where were we? يعني صح. I know عشان كان في فريق وبعدين it didn't exist and then it came back and everything. But these are little girls and so many people are telling them they'll never be as successful as the guys are. But look at the American soccer team. They won the Olympics or whatever, the World Cup. مش فاكرة حد يقول لي. They won. So it means that they're good. Like there's it's there. And it's things like this. And Benedi, they work really hard. They're really good players. They train like crazy. It's at the expense of their education, at the expense of their personal lives. They do these things. عشان دلوقتي in this day and age, we have to let our girls and the women around us do what they want to do. لو صح لو غلط. If they're gonna make a mistake, let them do it. Just let them do it. Don't let any. A girl doesn't have to be a ballet dancer or I was.
So
and I was a girly girl. Come on. But they don't have to. They can work hard, be good at a sport, be good at something that's dominated from a male industry. خلاص بقى.
You need to choose. You need to choose. Maybe you don't want to have a kid.
Come on, it's your choice. Maybe you can't. Maybe you can't. By the way, this is what annoys me. I know so many people who go through struggles. And they're always asked the question, طب إيه؟ ما أنتوا بقالكم مثلا متجوزين, I don't know how long, أو أنتوا يعني
غير إن هي insensitive, you need to, as يعني the girls now and the women now, في العالم كله الموضوع ده ابتدى, فإحنا دايما متأخرين شوية, بس no problem. You need to give them the choice. يعني أنا فاكرة في المدرسة, I was on the soccer team, not because I know how to play, but because it was fun.
Yeah.
And they always used to say to us, like, ايه هتبرلكوا يبقى جسمكوا عامل زي الولاد, مين هيبصلكوا, هتتجوزوا ازاي, دايما هتتجوزي ازاي. This is always repeated. لا لازم يبقى في اختيار, انا هختار اتجوز او لا, او مش دلوقتي, اخلف, العب كوره, العب باليه, اقعد في البيت, لا اخرج, لا اشتغل. كفايه boundaries, كفايه limitations, عشان then البنت بتبقى قاعده هامله كده ومخها. Women think a lot, like you think with both sides of your brain.
24 ساعه
ايوه, وبنفكر في حاجات زياده. يعني يعني ال الشخص العادي مثلا بيفكر to a certain surface, واحنا بندخل في الديتيلز قوي.
ولما يبقى كل حد بيسالك نفس الحاجه, that's how you produce generations of insecure
100%.
Girls that don't have any confidence in their choices or in anything, for they start to follow the box checking method. طبعا. Because اللي هو طب انا عندي كل التفكير ده بس انا غلط, كل حد بيقول لي لازم اعمل كذا, طب لازم اعمل كذا, او ماي جاد انا حصل كذا, عمري في حياتي ما حد هيتجوزني او ما حدش هيعباني. صح,
يو كرييت ذس. المشكله ان ده هدفك. لما يو تشينج ثينجز اور يو وري اباوت ثينجز عشان هدفك, انا هتجوز ازاي؟
مأساة قوي. لا دي هتودي. بس عايز اقول حاجه في غير انه في اللي هو الحته اللي هما بيحطونا فيها كبنات, انه انت مفروض مكانك في البيت مع جوزك مع عيالك. دلوقتي السوشيال ميديا بقى يحطك في شكل ان انت لازم تبقي شكلك بيرفكت كده, المفروض يبقى شعرك ناعم وتقيل وطويل, لازم يبقى
جسمك وجلدك
وجسمك عامل كده, لازم انت تبقي بنت قوي.
And يعني if you are, then you're a bimbo or you're stupid or you're not taken seriously.
أيوة.
How many rooms have you been in and you could already sense no one's taking you seriously because you're beautiful?
So many rooms, I couldn't even fit them into a man.
And you too. And you too. فروما, you have to look a certain way and when you do, no one's gonna take you seriously.
ماشي, بس هقول لك على حاجة, بس ده برضو مشكلة social media, مشكلة الناس اللي على social media.
Sorry, أنا عايز أقول حاجة بس ونرجع. لما أنا بكلم إنه إزاي بيكلموا ستات ويسألوا مسألة, أنا مش بلوم الرجالة, أنا بلوم الرجالة والستات عشان a lot of women have that mentality.
بلوم الستات أكتر من الرجالة.
Both. بس back to social media كمان بتلاقي بنات they're married and they're mothers and they make everything look so perfect, easy. And I'm sure it's not easy. يعني أكيد أنا كنت بشوف مامتي, يعني we had help and بس my mom was very involved and everything. ومامتي كانت مش لاحقة يعني, and we were two girls. ولا we're not شقية, like we're not at all. We were super nice girls. بس هي ما كانتش. أنا بشوف صحابي دلوقتي شيرين ودانيا وكلهم with their kids, they're going crazy.
Yeah.
ما ينفعش إن إحنا on social media نقعد. يعني أنا مثلا ساعات I have a love-hate relationship with social media. I hate social media. أنا شايفة ما أعرفش أستعمله. But every once in a while, بدخل في mood معين, I'm like, okay, I can do this and whatever. I look at my pictures sometimes, I'm like, it's not me. But then again, I don't have, ما عنديش ال guts to show who I am for one reason. عشان أنا طلعت من reality show. But so many people saw too much. فأنا بالنسبة لي دلوقتي, I just draw the line. You know what I mean? Like, I try to be as relatable as possible. But please respect that I'm not going to let you into my house.
You're not going to allow yourself to be this vulnerable. There's like a
which is why I do love hate relationship with social media. And حاسة إنه طبعاً if I could do more, I should do more and whatever. But it's not me anymore.
Yeah.
It's not my character.
Yeah. I feel like it's a double-edged sword, Yani. On one side, you allow all these people to realize that there's other people like them in the world. Mm-hmm. Like, I think a lot of the things that have shifted over the last couple of years was because of social media. And at the same time, you as a viewer, I think you can't really control the content because it's so much easier to show when things are good than when they're bad. Like, it's no one's fault. It just is what it is.
But come in, when someone shows that something's bad, you don't always know, like, how genuine they are. You know what I mean? Like, like, you know, when you show too much,
they question your sanity.
The sanity, yes.
Right? You're like, oh my God, what's wrong with this person?
يعني أنا حاجة بيعيط مثلا على ستوري, I'm like, لا. كنت ممكن ما تصوريش الموضوع ده.
بس everyone wants to see it. That too much. You know what I mean? هو أنت بتعمل كده for the show.
But I think what I'm trying to say is, as someone who's tuning in, and you're going in to look, you need to know in the back of your mind
that not everything's real.
There's no rush. There's no timer or ticker. It's not as perfect as it is. I show all the good things and it just happens to be this way. And I know that that's not 100% of the reality. You need to see with that same lens when you're looking at people. You have to be mindful of what you're looking at.
سهلة عليك ان انت تقولي كده. خالص.
هي مش سهلة.
Teenagers, السن الصغير بيبص على انستغرام, هو مصدق 100% انه الناس دي حياتها كده. وعشان كده في ناس كتير قوي الامباكت بتاع انستغرام انه بيجي لهم, البنات دي بتجيلها ديبرشن.
بيبقى في unrealistic expectations على reality. يعني انا مثلا حتى عشان كده ساعات بزعل من نفسي من الموضوع ده, عشان انا الفان بيس بتاعي اصغر. بتفرج على السوشيال ميديا بتاعي بقول انه there's nothing that makes these girls feel like they can relate to me. بس أنا كمان, I don't have the kind of شخصية أو character إن أنا أقعد أدخل الناس في حياتي. أنا للأسف مش كده. It's not me. It's always an inner struggle.
بس عملي كيف في stories.
ساعات أنا
لو أنا هبص على your Instagram profile, فإنه صور كلها لارا طبعاً, إنه صور فاهمة ده شغلها, ده حاجات مثلاً عاملة إعلان ماجازين مش عارف إيه والحاجات دي كلها. بس في الستوريز بتاعتها بتبقى بتتريق على نفسها كتير قوي.
اه بس الستوري بتاعتي قليله جدا عشان من كتر ما انا عارفه ان انا وحشه في الحاجات دي وبتريق على نفسي. ما ينفعش كل مره اتريق على نفسي عشان بغلط يعني ما بعرفش اتكلم الكاميرا يعني كميه المرات مثلا عملت ستوريز وبعدين I was like ايه ده ايه ده مين دي باي ديليت like you idiot what are you doing so I'm so bad at this بس عشان كده بقول يعني I'm not there on social media to teach anyone a lesson. I'm not there to have people like relate to me if they don't feel like they do. If they do, then amazing. I'm just there because it's my job to be there. عشان when I can connect, I want to connect. But for me, it's not a platform to, oh my God, like this is what I do.
It's not a lens into reality. But I think
when that does. My reality is not on social media and I want everyone to understand that.
Yeah, but I think what that does is that it sparks conversations like this.
Mm-hmm.
Like I think this might be one of the first conversations that you have that are pretty, it's not about what's been produced or what you're working on next. It's really just about getting to know you. And I think, because I've been on the receiving end of, oh my God, I'm not doing enough, I'm not this enough, I'm not this enough. And then through conversation, I realized, Ida, you too, you've been through this, you feel the same. Ida, you
feel the same.
Let's have these conversations and let's have these conversations بنات عرب. Because it's not that easy to relate to people abroad because their expectations are different and the society is different. I'm really happy you came today.
Thank you. I'm happy.
And I'm really glad we talked about all these things.
Me too. I was excited to learn from you. It was therapy. Like, yeah. I'm going to go home. Therapy. I'm going to hug my husband. Thank you. I love you.
I'm really happy. I learned a lot. And I love when I see someone doing something they love to do, doing it their way, especially when they're getting shit for it. Because then I'm like, okay, I really respect that. Because it's hard. It makes sense later. It's very easy to judge when you don't understand in the beginning. Easy. But nothing's easy.
Mm. If it were, we wouldn't be living.
No.
Yes, salam.
And you figure
it. Yes, salam.
Aristotle.
That's not what he
said. I know. I'm just calling myself Aristotle. It's Lara Scandar, by the
What's,
way.
It's Lara Scandar.
Read that quote. Read that quote in your next podcast. Be like Lara Scandar once said.
What did you say?
Life isn't easy. If it were, we wouldn't be living.
Okay.
Not everything in life is easy. I don't know. Spin it whatever way
Just
you
decide
want.
On the way you want
to
say
I'll
it.
I'll send it to you with a picture of myself in black and white. I'll put it.
Lara, hey, come out.
Yeah, but I like so much girls.
Okay.
But I liked it. It was fun.
Uh-huh.
Shukran, Anafika. Thank you.
Bye-bye.